Okay. On spécifique. So this has certainly been largely debated, I'm aware, you know, in old school. I must tell you that the MIC at the level of the bank, the MIC has been set up for a specific purpose in a context that is very specific. And that's where I say unconventional measures were also needed. It continues to deliver on the mandate for which it has been set up, and it will continue to deliver so, up till such time that you know, the economy is back on track, and then we can start discussing about all this stuff. But as of now, our priority remains on the fact that we need to preserve stability, we need to preserve soundness of our banking system. And this is what it will continue on delivering on.
Monsieur le Premier, que répondez-vous à ceux qui vous accusent d'avoir pris de l'argent public, d'avoir mis sur MIC, et aujourd'hui, on se cache MIC pour pas répondre?
Look, I mean, the MIC has been set up with a very clear and distinct mandate here. You know, I mean, it's been there for a specific purpose, and it continues to be there for that specific purpose. If you see today in the country,
so you would prefer to say aujourd'hui que c'est totalement transparent ce que la MIC fait?
Oh yes, definitely. I must tell you, as the shareholder, we do get reports certainly not on specific files, but on the broader way in which the MIC is operating. And I must tell you that all procedures have been very closely adhered to, as for the reports that we receive. As it is, that is why we have...
Si c'est aussi transparent, pourquoi ne pas publier?
But that's why I say, the processes have been really being followed too. Everything, basically, the A to Z of the processes have been followed too. And now, on specific files, this is where I would invite you again to go and contact the MIC. On specific questions, but I'm also aware of the fact that we are, you know, very much in the banking sector and the financial sector, that you do have provisions of specific contracts. You have the provisions of the law also that must be respected with respect to each financial transaction. But keeping all of that and operating within the ambit of the legality of affairs, basically, certainly.
C'est ça la critique du leader de l'opposition, parce que là on ne parle pas de l'argent privé, on parle de l'argent public, ou la transaction entre un banquier et un client, ça ne se pose plus. Parce que l'emprunt de l'argent public, c'est pas de l'argent privé.
But financial transactions are, again, these are parties that agree between themselves, basically, what are the specificities of legal arrangements. I wouldn't have those details with me. But certainly, again, I tell you, if you have specific questions, do direct them to the MIC and they will see.
La question du leader de la commission, c'est que toutes les compagnies qui ont bénéficié de cet argent ont fait valoir une clause de confidentialité.
As far as I understand, yes, but again, I would tell you, specific details I wouldn't know. As the shareholder of the MIC, at the level of the bank, we are given information on the procedures, basically. It is and remains an autonomous entity that has its own management. It is and remains an autonomous entity that has its own board that takes decision. So specific questions and specific details must be directed to those to the MIC directly.
Est-ce que le rapport de la banque a fait un bilan de des activités de, du?
Oh yes, definitely. I must also say, you know, when I look at the website of the MIC, I see that you know they have started. You know, as far as possible, disclosed quite a number of information already. And the annual report of the bank, when it will be published, will also contain, you know, that report of the MIC.
Donc, vous n'êtes pas d'accord avec la Banque mondiale quand il dit que le MIC devrait être plutôt du côté de Consolidated Fund?
Look, I think we are, again, we have to put things in context. You know, I mean, the MIC, again, I would say it has been created, has been set up with a specific purpose in a very specific condition in this country. We are very much at the start of the economic recovery phase, and I think the MIC still has a lot to deliver on. And it has to be able to walk us together, complement whatever policy stances that we take in, to be able to deliver on the mandate that we have to deliver.
Toujours reprenant les paroles du leader de l'opposition, quand il vient dire que pour le stimulus package, tout a été déclaré. Quelle différence il y a?
Look, the MIC is, as I said it again, I mean, the MIC is a private company. And it is a private company that operates under the provisions of the Companies Act, basically of the country. It is a company that is investing in specific projects, even in the case of distressed companies, as well as in the case of future generation projects, basically, the MIC is investing and will be generating return. It is not distributing money freely. It is investing, and investments basically have to reap returns.
Je pense que c'est quand même, quand le leader de l'opposition, quand même, bien avec deux allégations très directes qu'on ne peut pas répondre. Que la MIC ne juge pas approprié de répondre et au moins de donner quelques informations.
Look, again, you are asking something very specific to the MIC. I would invite you to ask specifically to the MIC. As the shareholder of the MIC, again, as I say it, it is a company that is autonomous, it is a company that is independent, and I respect very much the independence and the autonomy of that company. This is why it has not, it has its own management, it has its own board. So I will again invite you to direct the question that you have specifically on MIC to the management of the MIC. Okay?
Il y a cette compromise autour de la banque, autour de vous, autour du poste du gouverneur, etc., pour dire que vous êtes devenu un genre de couper dans la main du ministre des Finances et que tout doit passer par les finances, etc., etc., avant de prendre une décision, même avec la MIC, etc. Qu'est-ce que vous avez à répondre à toutes ces allégations? Parce que nous n'avons pas entendu beaucoup de choses durant ces derniers six mois du bord de la Banque de Boris et même de vous en tant que gouverneur. Qu'avez-vous à dire à cela?
We are an independent organization. Central banks around the world remain very independent and very autonomous in the way in which they operate, basically. And And this is a principle, a fundamental principle that I respect also. And I'm very serious about maintaining the independence of the central bank. Independence, as I've said it in the past also, does not mean that in periods of crisis, you do not look in the same direction. What the Bank of Mauritius has done, as has been the case, I must say, for all central banks around the world, if you look at all countries around the world, you would see from the US to the UK to India to everywhere, basically, you name it, and you would see all countries in the world, basically, in this pandemic period, they have started and they continue to look in the same direction because it is very important that you do have complementary monetary and fiscal sensors to be able to accompany the countries and the economies out of this difficult situation in which it is. We should not forget that we are not in normal times. We should not forget that we have challenges in front of us, that we're living challenges that have not been seen before. This country hasn't had such an experience before. So, as is the case, and as is the practice basically a bit around the world, central banks are all working in the same direction, looking rather in the same direction, but while maintaining their independence. And this is the case, I can assure you, that at the level of the bank, decisions of the bank are taken by the board, by the bank, by me, by my two deputies. We have a board that is completely independent. No one dictates the central bank, but it does not mean that in such difficult situations that we do not look in the same direction in the interest of the country to be able to assure ourselves and ensure ourselves that our policy stances are able to take the country out of the difficulty in which it is. But let me reassure and let me say it out and loud and very clear again in a recent press interview I did it. More recently, I think a couple of weeks ago, I maintain the fact that the independence of this institution, which is the most respected institutions of the country, basically is very much here. Our decisions are taken by ourselves. Our decisions are not taken in consultation with X, Y, or Z. You know, we are an independent organization. We have independent professionals here, and we will continue to operate the way it is.
Thank you. Par rapport à la non-remboursement, éventuel non-remboursement de certaines compagnies bénéficiaires de la MIC, que cela pourrait déstabiliser la balance de la Banque centrale et donc affecter all monetary policies. Donc, est-ce que cela a été pris en compte aussi?
I must tell you, yes. I think that investments that have been done by the MIC basically have been looked into from all aspects. Because, as I say again, for us, it's an investment. Basically, that has been done is an investment to accompany the country out of this difficult phase right now, but it remains an investment and it must translate into returns.
Dans le cadre de ce, est-ce que vous vous assurez que Coca-Canor boiteux ne bénéficie de l'aide de...
Again, this is a question that you need to ask to the MIC. Basically, I cannot go on specific.
Would it not be better?
I can tell you as the shareholder of the MIC, we've been very clear to the MIC that, you know, we need to see returns at the end of the day.
After so much time, after so much critics, would it have been better that the board of the MIC holds a press conference?
Again, your question must be addressed to the MIC. But I'm all for transparency.
Par rapport aux estimations pour le tourisme aérien, quelles sont les projections de la Banque centrale pour atteindre le revenu? Et ça c'est une deuxième question qui est liée au taux de change qui est passé à 42,50 stabilisé autour de au mois de juillet et toujours troisième question par rapport à 42,50 est-ce que c'est le taux de change où la banque centrale est plus se sent plus à l'aise avec ce taux de change.
Let me take one more. I mean, your last two questions are interrelated, you know, on the FX rate, as I said it in my statement also. The way we intervene, and this is very important because I've been hearing quite a lot of things again, I mean, in the recent past, I would say. The way the bank intervenes and sells FX on the market is through a very transparent process. We intervene basically through an auction system, which is an established practice at the level of the bank. It is a system that is in line with international best practices also. So what happens basically when we look at the positions of the market from an FX perspective, when we see that together with banks, treasurers of banks, when we see that there is a need to intervene and to supply FX on the market, the bank then communicates on the amount of FX that it wants to put on sale, basically. And for that particular amount, each commercial bank would be submitting their bids, basically. It is by so doing that we look at a range that is received at the level of the bank, and the bank always intervenes within this bid range, I would say, that we receive from the market, basically. So this is the practice, and this will continue to be the practice. Certainly, our priority certainly is to ensure that there is a constant supply of FX on the market. Our priority continues to be that the processes are smooth as possible and that there is no undue volatility that is created, basically. So the rate which we see today is very much dependent on the market. And this is why we say, and we've been saying it in the past also, that we remain highly committed to an FX system, which is a free float regime, basically. The free float regime means that it is a market determined rate that we look at, and this is the practice that will continue to be, basically. Coming on to your first question in terms of what is expected revenue that we are seeing or that we're forecasting from the tourism sector, basically. I must say that if everything goes back to normal, we should be able to achieve, if the last quarter is to perform as per our assumptions, we should be able to achieve at least the same amount of inflows that we had achieved last year during our peak, which was January to March, basically, roughly, which is around anything between 20 to 25 billion Mauritian rupees of FX equivalent. So this is what would be the expected. But again, it's all depending on how the markets react.
On dit souvent qu'il y a un lien entre la dépréciation de la dévaluation ou la dépréciation de la roupie et l'inflation, le coût de la vie, est-ce que vous...
Well, certainly, obviously, there would be a link. Huh? I mean, if you depreciate, when a currency depreciates, I mean, it does create some level of inflation. But I must say that the inflation that we're seeing in the country, as is the case again around the world, is mainly driven by supply side shocks, basically, that we're seeing. It's not really anything else.
Vous avez parlé de la FATEC. Vous pensez que donc là, cette visite-là est un silver lining, hein? C'est un signe d'espoir, ça, cette visite.
We remain optimistic, in my capacity as the head of the Mauritius delegation, I've been leading all the discussions so far at the level of the entire process since last year. In my capacity as the head of the Mauritian delegation, I can tell you that I remain confident and optimistic. We put in a lot of efforts. We've really had all institutions gear up. I also chair the ICC, the Inter-Coordination Committee, which regroups all regulators with an AML-CFT mandate. I must say that I'm pretty much satisfied with the work that has been done, that we've achieved so far, and we remain optimistic that we can achieve something. But again, it all depends on the outcome of this.
Vous pensez que votre prévision de croissance de 5.5% est plus réaliste que 9%?
9%, oui.
C'est-à-dire que le ministre parle de croissance de 9%.
Non. For this year, this calendar year, 5.5% is what, based on current assumptions that we have, is what we forecasting. This is the stand of the bank, 5.5% for this calendar year.
en tant que gouverneur de la Banque de Maurice, est-ce que vous demandez à la MIC, quand les questions seront adressées, est-ce que vous lui demandez de répondre à ces questions?
I can tell you, yes, that my communications department will follow up with them. I mean, as far as possible, within the legality of things, as I say, certainly the communications department will Mr. Fanat can vote in it.
Certainly, I will make myself I will make it a must to forward the questions to the MIC team. But this being said, we'll try and have them respond to your questions as soon as they can.
Good.
There's no question from the floor. Thank you.
Thank you once again. And thank you for being present today.